also thank you everybody for hearing tonight. You know, like I said, tonight is the expose of like no cursing tonight. So thank you, I appreciate that for holding it down. Thank you. I even have to get myself on. He's like, damn. No, one thing I explained to some of the other brothers was this, man. As an artist, I think every artist shows your versatility and understand when you walk into certain environments, how to handle certain environments. You know what I mean? It doesn't change anything as an artist. You just know how to deliver. You know, you got different styles of pitches. That's all that makes up. That's how I look at it. So anyways, y'all still bringing that heat, so thank you for doing that. All right, so on deck, I got you signed up. You still going to rock out, Haiti? You still, okay, I got you then. Okay, cool. All right, so let me tell you who's on deck. On deck, we got Christian Wright. Then we got Joseph. But I get it right? I'm close? Okay. I'll put his phonetic. He saw me right here. He got me wrote phonetically. So I was trying to get it right. As a host, I really want to make sure I got your name right. Yeah. All right, so let me tell you who's coming up right now. This man right here has the smoothest voice in the poetry game. You know, and it's a pleasure for me to call him up to the mic. So can y'all please put your hands together for John, everybody. John, yes, sir.
I know it's good for the kids. Congratulations to the Cubs on winning the World Series. Yeah. I just heard a quick joke about a comic, but I heard that if Cleveland had won, that they would be the first team to win three championships. Cleveland Cavaliers won the NBA championship, the Indians would have won the World Series, and I heard that the Cleveland Browns would have won the Super Bowl in fantasy football. So ask me where they won't win. That's why I'm a poet.
They would even win in fantasy football.
Two poems, guys, they're both new, so I'm gonna read it slow. This first poem is entitled, Daughters of Eve. Yes, I opened the book and took a look at what took place in the Garden of Eden. What was said by the snake, what she ate by mistake, I even understood the reason. Did her daughters discern any lessons learned, or are you all still being misled? Put it in a love song if you suspect I'm wrong as I reflect on what you've read. Men lie, men cheat, men deny, men deceive. And you are right to a certain degree. Hate them, berate them, even debate them. Just do not look at me. Beautiful and smart, so why the broken heart? I would start by looking up above. So he's sweet like honey and make lots and lots of money. Funny, who thought you were marrying for love. Miss ill-advised, pulling the world over your own eyes. Your own heart leads you down the wrong path. Another boyfriend, another ex, another boyfriend, another next. Girlfriend, you do the man. Look, there is no serpent and there is no tree. It's your point of view that deceives you and your eyes that lies to me. Be mothers of the truth to help men comprehend and be wives of sympathize until there is no end. He is called the father of the lie, so be called wives who believe that your husbands can understand. Thank you, daughters of Eve. And this last poem is entitled, Every Man. Every woman has a need. Every man has a desire. Every woman has this need to be believed. To every man, this need is desire. You see, every woman has an art of first breaking a man's heart, his mind, his money, his soul. Every man will then start watching his world begin to fall apart. Does it occur to her his goal is controlling? No, I cannot keep your poem a secret. Your anxiety I will quietly unveil. In exchange for devotion, should I take in your emotion? I'm waiting for your girl to exhale. And she asked, if she asks if you want seconds, I suggest you beg it. Time ignores you, I suggest you ignore time. And you thought you were tired of hearing my poetry. And you thought you were tired of hearing my rhyme. I am anxious and eager. Impatient with fever. You are craving, raving with greed. Every man has a desire. To me, this is dire. You and I have a need to be relieved.
All right. Who's done, everybody?